Virtualization. Virtualization is being used by a growing number of organizations. So the concept of virtualization can simplify the operations in the IT sector, which allows these organizations to respond faster in changing demands. So what do you mean by virtualization? So virtualization is nothing but it is a process. It is a process of creating virtual environment on an existing server to run your desired program. So this does not interfere any of the other services which is provided by the server or the host platform, or you can say the physical machine. In computing, virtualization is being defined, or it is referred as the process of creating a virtual version of something. So it can be an operating system or a server, or it can be a network resources or a storage device. Okay. So what does the virtualization do? Or what is the role of virtualization? It allows you to run multiple applications and operating systems on the same server. So here we are making use of a single server, and this single server is being shared among multiple machines. So this provides an efficient resource utilization and helps in the reduction of cost. So in this picture, you can see the first one is without virtual machine, that is a normal physical machine. And the second one is the physical machine with multiple virtual machines on it, or single physical instance that is being shared among multiple users or multiple machines. So here you can see an additional layer, which is known as the hypervisor, which is also known as virtual machine monitor, VMM. So this is nothing but a thin software layer, which is responsible for creating, managing and controlling the virtual machines. Actually, hypervisor is the one who plays a major role in the creation of virtual machines. Okay, so now we'll see the working. So we all know that all the systems have physical resources like processor, memory, network utilities. So to make a virtual machine or to create a virtual environment, we make use of the hypervisor. Hypervisor is a thin software layer which acts as a link between the hardware and the virtual environment. So it is also known as the virtual machine monitor, VMM. So the hypervisor partitions, or more specifically you can say that it abstracts and isolates the different operating systems and applications from the underlying hardware. So this make use of the hardware, and through the hypervisor it can create multiple virtual machines. So therefore, we can say that virtualization is enabled by the functions of hypervisor. So another important role of hypervisor is that it ensures that all the virtual machines stay isolated from each other. So this helps when a problem occurs in one virtual machine, the others remain unaffected. Okay. And hypervisor also handles the communications among virtual machines over the virtual network, which enables the virtual machines to connect with one another. So when we discuss on the working of virtualization, the role of hypervisor is being discussed mainly. So the hypervisor can be of two types, that is type 1 and type 2. The most common form is known as the type 1, where the virtual layer sits on the hardware and virtualizes the hardware platform so that the multiple virtual machines can utilize it. That is what we discussed now in the working section. And the second one is a type 2 hypervisor, which uses the host operating system to create isolated guest virtual machines. The virtual machines is known as the guest operating systems, and the server that is known as the host system. Okay. Virtualization can be of different types, like hardware virtualization, software virtualization, operating system virtualization, server virtualization, storage virtualization. Virtualization provides numerous benefits like the reduction of cost, efficient utilization of resources, better accessibility, minimization of risk, among others.